Trying to think about the main problem behind this week. I think it's more about the heart than the stomach. I know it is. It's more about our hearts than our stomach, and I don't want to get too literal, but you know, heart disease is a big condition with obesity. But more than that, with our spiritual hearts, it's more about our heart than our stomach. Philippians chapter 3, Paul writes these words: Their end is destruction, their God is their belly, and they glory in their shame with mindset on earthly things. Other versions say their God is their stomach. Their God is their appetite. Boy, how true is that for so many Americans, or at least us from time to time, or every day, just depending on who you are. We all struggle with different things. Some of you this isn't a struggle with, but a lot of people it is, okay? Their God is their belly. But it's not just about eating, okay? And it's not just about food. It's about worship, is what I want to get across to you today. It's about our heart. It's about, where do I run for fulfillment? Where do I go for satisfaction? Where do I go for comfort? Where am I going for peace? Is it a pint of ice cream that I'm going to? Is it a drink that I'm going to try and make me happy or give me joy? Or am I satisfied in God and drinks and foods are bonuses? I don't want to say icing off the cake, but that's pretty accurate. Okay. Do we run to God and Jesus for what we really need in life? Or do we run to food? Or another addiction like we talked about last week? With food, we can have this unrestrained overconsumption. And that's the general definition for gluttony, unconstrained overconsumption. And it's where we turn a good thing, food is good, right? We need food to live. But we turn this good thing into a God thing. And that's where a lot of idols come up, where we turn even good things in life into God things. And they become too much of a focus. And we find all our joy and satisfaction and fulfillment in them instead of God and Jesus. Food's a gift. Food's a blessing. We need nutrients. But we can turn this blessing into a curse too easily with what we shove into our gullets, right? And we could distort the good gift that God has given to us. See, there's a fine line between loving pumpkin pie, anybody, or being a taco enthusiast, or being a coffee lover. And then it goes from that to, okay, I'm a taco worshiper. I'm a pumpkin pie worshiper. I'm a coffee addict. And we joke about these things. We're like, yeah, I just can't stop drinking coffee. And it's so funny, except we're crying on the inside because we know we literally can't stop drinking or eating this thing. And that is a problem. And food addiction is a real thing that we deal with. And it's socially acceptable, so we don't deal with it as much as we probably should. But there's hidden truth in joking. And we got to be careful with what we say and careful with what we put into our mouths. You can turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 in your Bibles, New Testament, over three-fourths of the way through, near the end. I want to share with you a lot of verses today, and I'm trying to be a little quicker. We're not going to turn to all of them. They are in your notes. There are a lot. I encourage you to read over these verses this week, pray over them, ask God, how do you want me to change? And if you're the average American, there's probably quite a bit on this that we need to change to follow God, Jesus, closer in our eating. So 1 Corinthians chapter 3, look at verse 16. Don't you realize that all of you together are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God lives in you? God will destroy anyone who destroys this temple. For God's temple is holy, and you are holy. You've probably heard that before, that your body is a temple. What does that mean? Is it a building? Sometimes they feel pretty thick, right? Like the rocks on a temple, like the bricks. Your body is a temple. God's Spirit is inside of us. If you are a Christian, living and breathing and moving inside of us. And we need to honor God with this body that He's given us. So we talk about a lot about money management. We're going to talk about money in a few weeks. I'm not going to tell you when, because then you won't come. But we're going to talk about money. And it's easy to say, oh yeah, manage your money well. God calls us to be good stewards of our money. And we get that concept. God's given these resources for us to manage. We want to do well. But it's harder to think God has given, and we don't like to think as much, God has given me this body. I need to manage it well. I need to be a good steward of my resources, of my body. I need to exercise. I need to eat right. Enjoy treats sometimes, but a treat every day isn't a treat. It's natural. It's a normal part of your diet. A treat, by definition, is not very often. Okay. We know we need to do all these things, but it's just harder to do. It's just so hard. time and energy and lacking motivation, and food's all around us, and my friends are eating the food, and the family's eating the food, and we buy all this stuff, and it tastes good. It's really hard, but we've got to remember that God gave us one body. We get one chance in this life to honor Him, to glorify Him with our body, to manage that body well. How are we doing with that opportunity? We got to ask ourselves.
Grande.